2017 is the 10-year anniversary of the first Death album. I think, look, first of all, I'm a music dork, I'm a music nerd, I went to music school, and I studied pretty much everything but heavy metal, because they don't really teach metal. I mean, there were a couple really great teachers who were guitar players who were like, you can't escape metal, you have to, like, talk about it and understand it. I took some classes at music school about, you know, advanced prog rock concepts, where we talk about King Crimson and Gentle Giant and shit like that, like, just cool, awesome shit that you never thought you'd be getting college credit to talk about. And then, meanwhile, I was kind of a closet shredder, so I'd literally go into a practice room that's the size and shape of a closet. I'd close the door and lock it and sit on the ground with my amp and at a whisper volume practice all my Yngwie Malmsteen licks and all my shred and all my Eddie Van Halen and all my, you know, Dream Theater and all the nerdy stuff that was just for me. And I thought, I'll never use this. This will never be a part of my life. And then I got, thank God, through comedy, I ended up finding a way to kind of rediscover all that stuff. Metal's important because it can do something that other genres of music can't do. It can get aggressive. It can get badass. There's a lot of music that's not going to be badass ever. And it can get really dramatic. And it can get very moody. If it wants to. It can have as many peaks and valleys as it wants to. It can have a lot of dynamic range, even though your guitars are up to 11 and your drums are in full volume and everything's mic'd and people are screaming. You can still get a dynamic range throughout that stuff, and that's kind of what this record is. So it's basically all of my influences from the 70s, from the 80s and 90s. Anything I heard, I get to use on this record. I get to be as dramatic as Andrew Lloyd Webber gets to be. And I'm not joking, there is a moment on this record, Gene brought up this one part of a song, and he goes, this reminds me of this one moment in Evita. And I go, yes. And I'm sure there are tons of metal guys out there that got into Jesus Christ Superstar, or Evita. In this case, it was Evita. It's pretty nerdy and it's pretty dorky, and that's what this record is, basically. All bets are off.